हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला। आई एम प्रोफेसर एसपी सिंह फ्रॉम फैकल्टी ऑफ मैनेजमेंट स्टडीज़, गुरुकुल कांगड़ी यूनिवर्सिटी, हरिद्वार। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी मॉड्यूल 2, फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ रिसर्च प्रॉब्लम। आफ्टर स्टडिंग दिस मॉड्यूल, यू शैल बी एबल टू नो द नेचर ऑफ रिसर्च प्रॉब्लम, understand the process of problem identification, comprehend the components of a well-defined problem, understand the theoretical foundation and model building, become aware of the statement of research objectives. The research really begins when the researcher perceives some problem demanding a solution falling within the area of general topic he selects. This general area of interest merely defines the range of subject matter within which the researcher has to see and pose a specific problem of research. The general area only demarcates where to seek for the problem without specifying the exact problem. Defining the research problem. A research problem needs to be identified and clearly defined. The research problem is a statement, an area of concern, a condition to be improved upon, a difficulty to be eliminated, or a troubling question that exists in scholarly literature, in theory, or in practice, that points to the need for meaningful understanding and deliberate investigation. The research problem defines the goal of a research in clear terms. Without a clear-cut idea of the goal to be achieved, research task would become a worthless exercise. The statement of the problem is one of the most important parts of research. Process of problem identification. The problem recognition process invariably starts with the decision maker and some difficulty or decision dilemma that he or she might be facing. This is an action-oriented problem that addresses the question of what the decision maker should do. The broad decision problem has to be narrowed down to information-oriented problem, which focuses on the data of information required to arrive at any meaningful conclusion. Management decision problem. The problem identification process begins with the acknowledgement and identification of the difficulty encountered by the business manager or researcher. Discussion with subject experts. Here, discussions with industry and subject experts take place. These individuals are knowledgeable about the industry as well as the organization. Review of existing literature. A literature review is a comprehensive compilation of the information obtained from published and unpublished sources of data in the specific area of interest to the researcher. This may include journals, newspapers, magazines, reports, government publications, and also computerized databases. The organizational context. Another significant source for deriving the research problem is the industry and organization data. In case the research investigator is the manager himself, the data might be easily available. The organization context might not be essential in case of a basic research, where the nature of a study is more generic. Sometimes the expert interview, secondary data, and organizational information might not be enough to define the problem. In such a case, an exploratory qualitative survey might be required to get an insight into the behavior or perceptual aspects of the problem. Theoretical foundation and model building. A well-defined research problem comprises of the following components. The unit of analysis. The researcher must specify in the problem statement the individual from whom the research information is to be collected and on whom the research results are applicable. Research variables. The research problem also requires identification of the key variables under the particular study. It becomes imperative to convert the concepts and constructs to be studied into empirically testable and observable variables. A variable is generally a symbol to which we assign numerals or values. Dependent variable. The most important variable to be studied and analyzed in research study is the dependent variable. The entire research process is involved in either describing this variable or investigating the probable causes of the observed effect. Independent variable. Any variable that can be stated as influencing or impacting the dependent variable is referred to as an independent variable. The proposed relations are then tested through various research designs. Moderating variables. Moderating variables are the ones that have a strong contingent effect on the relationship between the independent and dependent variables. These variables have to be considered in the expected pattern of relationship as they modify the direction as well as the magnitude of the independent-dependent association. In a study, the relationship between attitude and purchase intention might be modified by the education and the income level of the buyer. Here, education and income are the moderating variables. Here, education and income are the moderating variables. Intervening variable. An intervening variable has a temporal connotation to it. It generally follows the occurrence of the independent variable and precedes the dependent variable. For example, an increase in job satisfaction of each individual worker subsequent to the introduction of a flexi-time work schedule, which eventually affects the individual productivity, especially among women employees. Extraneous variables. Extraneous variable could affect the defined relationship but might have been excluded from the study. This would most often account for the chance variation observed in the research investigation. For example, family pressures or nature of the industry could impact the flexi time impact. But since these would be applicable to individual cases, they might not heavily impact the direction of the findings. However, if the effect is substantial, the research might try to block their effect by using an experimental and a control group. Statement of research objectives. Once the research questions are formulated, they need to be broken down and spelled out as tasks or objectives that need to be met in order to answer the research questions. Here the researcher lays out exactly what is being planned by the proposed research. The research questions can be broken down into investigative questions. If the proposal is for a causal study, the objectives can be stated as a hypothesis. Based on the framework of the study, the researcher has to numerically list the thrust areas of research. Sometimes the main objectives of the study might need to be broken down into sub-objectives which clearly state the tasks to be accomplished. The objectives flow naturally from the problem statement, giving the sponsor specific, concrete and achievable goals. It is best to list the objectives either in order of importance or in general terms first, moving to specific terms later. The research objectives are the basis for judging the remainder of the proposal and ultimately the final report. Verify the consistency of the proposal by checking to see that each objective is discussed in the research design, data analysis, and results section. Friends, in this module you have studied the concept, definition of the research problem, process, research identification, theoretical foundation, and model building, statement of the research problem. Thanks for visiting EPG Pathshala.